So I'm on my way to Konstanz. That's where Konstanz University is. I'm going to be covering and showing the campus tour of that university. I was here in Furtwangen. There is a university called as HFU, Hochschule Furtwangen. They had pretty awesome courses, so that's what brought me to this place. And from here, I'm taking another train, which is going to take me about an hour or hour and a half, roughly, to get to Konstanz. So finally I've reached here at Konstanz. That was a good journey for about 1.5 hours. Got a lot of work done on the way. So we are almost at the tip of southern Germany. You just take a ferry from here, you'll end up in Switzerland. I have a friend who's gonna come and join us very quickly. Alright guys, so finally I've reached in front of University of Konstanz. This is the main gate, A5. The fastest way to get here would be the bus service, which will drop you right next to the main building. So here's my friend. Do you want to quickly introduce yourself to my audience?
Hey, hi. I am from Mumbai. I am currently doing my PhD over here. So I have been staying here for last 1 year. I did my bachelor's in physics and master's in photonics and currently working in photonics in over here.
Do you like Konstanz?
Yeah, really, I love it. I have visited many other places apart from Konstanz, and this is where I come to at the end. It's like, it feels like home now.
Right, yeah. Right. It definitely strikes a balance between the business world and the peace, what you really need for better growth in life. This is a very famous spot in whole of Germany. The connectivity from Konstanz to other countries is very easy. I will definitely show you the Swiss border in this video only. So if somebody is flying for the first time, what flight route would you suggest them to get to Konstanz?
Easiest one, I would suggest the one which I took. As I am from Mumbai, I flew from Mumbai to Zurich. And from Zurich, you can actually take a train which runs every 15 minutes and directly ends in Konstanz. The good thing about Zurich airport is, like, as soon as you get down off the airport, you are directly at the train station. Right. So you don't have to travel a lot to and find the train station. So you are directly at the train station. And then from there, you directly come to Konstanz. So you don't need any assistance of someone that, okay, you are coming with heavy luggage and stuff and you have to walk a lot. So this is one good thing about Zurich. But if you're planning to save some money, you feel that Zurich is expensive, you can also come via Munich. You can directly take a flight from any city in India to Munich, and from Munich you can catch a bus or a train again to come back to Konstanz. So you are connected in various ways. So this is one of the entrances which we enter into the university. So this is one entrance, and there is one more entrance from there. So, and right beside the entrance there's a bookshop. So if you want to grab a book or a pencil, or you want to buy a book from outside, you can get it from here. It's like, if they don't have a book, they will order it for you and they will get it for you. So it's a good service over here. So what you see outside is a central square, which is an open space where people hang out. There you see is way for the cafeteria. So you just go to the cafeteria. So now we just came in from the A5 building to the central square. So this square is famous, like, we just sit here and grab a cup of coffee. This is because we have just a Mensa right beside us.
That's right here.
Yeah, and this is like, this is a Mensa. And then that's the gate from which we entered in.
That's the gate, yeah.
And then this building. This building is the administrative building. So all the administrative process happen over here.
Right here in the administrative building, there are also other offices. For example, international offices there. There is CZIT, which is responsible for accommodation.
Yes.
Right. So we'll quickly show you around. The yellow building, what you see is Mensa.
So there's a CZIT office over here, this CZ office is here to help you out. So if you are in need for anything or you want to lodge a complaint or something, then you come over here.
If somebody wants, somebody who's freshly arrived, they need accommodation, is this the office? The cable block?
Yes. So when you freshly arrive over here, you kind of get your accommodation early itself. Before coming, you get your accommodation early itself. So to collect your keys and stuff, you come over here and collect your keys. So you just go to the...
I wanted to ask you, how's life in Constance, by the way, for students?
So life in Constance is really good. When you say it's an international community and you get to meet a lot of people, most of them are Erasmus students, so there is a possibility that you meet people for 6 months and after 6 months they are gone.
Mm-hmm.
But then too, it's like good, you have a good Indian community also over here, so there are some people who are working and in companies, so you meet them, they are with families and stuff. Also you have a student community which is a small group, but it's a good group with mixed people. Mm-hmm. And so it's like if you are missing your chole bhature, there will be some Punjabi guy who will make you a chole bhature. Or you want to eat some idli dosa, there will be a South Indian to make you a idli dosa. So you have a mixed variety of people over here. So it's like kind of fun. And summers in Constance is really good because the lake is so awesome. You can do multiple things like swimming, paddling, kayaking. You can do n number of stuff. It's a really beautiful city to be at.
Can you name some dormitories where students are staying here in Constance?
There are various dormitories over here. So the major organization which arranges the dormitories is the organization named CZI. To name some of the dormitories, one is Sonanbul West, Sonanbul West 2. Then there is one Sonanbul Oak House. Then there is one called Sonanbul Gruppen House. These are located in Yakobukastrasse. Yakobukastrasse is just like 10 minutes away from the university by walk. There are some accommodation arranged near to the city center because there is another part of University of Constance which is called Hattevega, which is a technical university. So there the university, the hostel names are basically Paradise, there are Europa House. These are two major hostels. And apart from that, there are some other private accommodation centers also, dorms like Tebea and CBH and stuff like that. Like if you don't get an accommodation in CZ, then you can also approach this private dorms and other facilities.
Since we are on the point of accommodation, what is the cost of living here?
So generally the cost of living for accommodation is generally like somewhere in the range of 320 to 360. So that's what CZ charges you for your room. It depends on how many people are living in the room as well as your room size.
So there are different types of accommodation. The more privacy you want, you end up paying more.
For students, it's normally like 100 euros to 120 euros for insurance. And as well as for food, in on a general basis, I guess people can pay around like 150 to 200 per month as per their food requirements.
Yeah, yeah.
Cube which we see and the building which is associated to it is the L building. L building is mainly Department of Chemistry. So all the chemistry students coming over here kind of work in L building. This is R building. So this R building is considered as an auditorium where majorly if you have a conference or a talk and there are many number of people coming. So this building is preferred because this has the largest seating. Right now we are at level B4. So here there are two offices over here. One is the library and second is the SSC. So when I talk about library, it's just not for lending books. It's also for your initial email account validation by the university. So when you join, you get an email ID from the university, which is used for connecting to the Wi-Fi and other purposes also. So everything is connected by the university email ID. So therefore you have to come here. There's a center called KIM service. So they are in charge of the software and everything related to that. And the second office is SSC. SSC handles your enrollment and your ID card related matters. So you have to come here for your ID card and also your enrollment certificate.
The SSC is also international office?
No.
It's a different one?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Yes. So this is SSZ. And that's where the yellow thing what you see. So that's library. So where are we right now?
This is the citizen's office. Yeah. So once you come to Constance and have settled in Constance, first thing you have to do is register in the city. This is a mandatory thing in the city that you have to register in the city and be a citizen of this city. So this is the office where you do that. Also, apart from registering in the city, when you have to extend your visa or get a residence permit, you again come to this place so that they provide you with the required things.
Right. As he said, this is the first thing you're supposed to do. City registration is a paper which will then help you to unblock your blocked account if you're coming here with one. Regarding the visa extension thing here, when you're entering the country, you will only be granted 3 to 6 months of visa as an entry visa. But to get that visa extended to a period of your studies, this is the office you have to come when you're in Constance. So this train, what you see, is going to Switzerland right here. This is where the main station of Constance is. And guess what? Right now, I'm on the border of Germany and Switzerland. So this is the border of Germany, and this is where Switzerland actually starts. So how do I know this? Is if you look at this, this is where it says Bundesrepublik Deutschland, and this side is Switzerland. This is where it says Kreuzlingen. This is where officially Switzerland starts. Isn't it interesting how you could just walk through this area? You've been on a mission to take my pride away from me. You don't ever listen, and you live with your complacency. You don't scare me, but you should feel me. The sun is setting, don't trust your hearing. You made a monster of your imposter. Go ahead and wander, but don't trust the water. No. With your complacency.